Good morning, everyone. I hope everybody had a nice, enjoyable, soggy weekend. We certainly needed the rain, so that was kind of nice to see. But it kept us inside, or at least it kept me inside. Anyway, I want to review with you what I started with you last week. And by the way, we only have two more lessons to go, and that's going to be it for this trimester. We'll call it quits, and then we'll just review the things that we've learned since the beginning of distance learning to take us through the end. So, but just a couple more lessons. So we're almost home, guys. Summertime is almost here. Anyway, I wanted to review with you what I talked about last week, Wednesday, Thursday, whenever that was. The important property that the nth root of x raised to the n is equal to x. And I was looking at some of your work, and particularly that last problem, I gave you that intentionally just to see if you guys could see that there's an easier way to go about doing this. But let's say here I have the cube root of x raised to the 6 here. Okay, so I can break the cube root of x raised to the 6 into product of 2. Radicals, and that's the cube root of x raised to the third times the cube root of x to the third, and cube root of x to the third, that's just x, and then times x, and that gives me x squared. Well, some of you probably realize, and we're going to look at this today, that there's a little easier way to do this. All I have to do is take a look at the index 3 and the exponent 6, and I note that 6 is a multiple of 3. So 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2. Okay, so I see right away that this is going to simplify the cube root of x raised to the 6 is just going to simplify as x squared. Okay, or 6 divided by 3 gave me 2. So the next example here, so looking at that, do you really want to use that property, the nth root of x raised to the n is equal to x? For that example there, the cube root of x raised to 66, if you started that, you'd have the cube root of x raised to the third times the cube root of x to the third, but you'd have a lot of those, and how many of those would you have? Well, you would have 22 of them. Okay, so the easiest thing to do is just note that 66 divided by 3, because 66 is a multiple of 3, 66 divided by 3 is 22. So then here, this would just equal x raised to the 22nd. So, and again, we're going to look at the rational exponents today and see why that's the case. But that's an easier way to do that. All right, so today's lesson, so just to review with you. Okay, so as I just said here, so we had that problem there. The easiest way to do that would say, hey, that's the cube root of 27 times the cube root of x raised to the 99th. The cube root of 27 is 3, and then 99 divided by 3 is 33. So this would be 3 times x raised to 33. And then the next one here, the fourth root of 16, x raised to 61. So that would be 4, the fourth root of 16 times the fourth root. Now, 61 is not a multiple of 4. So the next smallest multiple of 4 would be 60, so that would be x, the fourth root of x raised to the 60th times the fourth root of just x, because 60 plus 1 is 61. So the fourth root of 16, that would be 2, and then 60 divided by 4, that would equal 15, and so this would be x raised to the 15th, and then finally what's left over is the fourth root of x. Okay. So we're going to look at the rational exponents property, okay, and so that would probably make a little more sense. All right, so but before we get there, we're going to just look at the next property here, quotient property of roots, which says that the nth root of a over b is equal to the nth root of a divided by the nth root of b. So I'll go through some examples there, and then we'll get into rational exponents. So here, so the cube root of 16x to the 6 over y to the 9th, I'll break that up into two parts there. So that is going to be the cube root of 16 x to the 6 over the cube root of y to the 9th using the quotient property of roots, and then I can break this up further. The largest cube root factor of 16 is 8, so this is going to be the cube root of 8 times the cube root of 2 times the cube root of x to the 6. And the cube root of 8 is equal to 2. And then looking at this here, 6 divided by 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2, so this is going to be x squared. And then what's left over is the cube root of 2. All divided by, so here I have, again, so I have 9 divided by 3 is going to equal 3, so this is going to be over y to the 3rd. All right, and so that was my final answer there. The next one, again, so this would be the cube root of 24, the largest perfect cube factor of 24 is 8, and then times the cube root of 3, because 3 times 8 is 24, times the cube root of x to the 3rd, all divided by the cube root of 27 times the cube root of y to the 6. Okay, so do the math here. The cube root of 8 is 2. And again, here the cube root of x to the 3rd, or 3 divided by 3 is 1, so that just leaves me with x. And then times the cube root of 3 divided by the cube root of 27 is 3. And then 6 divided by 3, so looking at that, 6 divided by 3 is 2, and so this is going to be y to the 2nd. The next one here, so again, breaking this up into two radical expressions, I have the square root of 25 divided by the square root of 3. The square root of 25 is 5 over root 3, and we should know we never leave a radical in the denominator, so we have to rationalize the denominator, so I'd multiply both the numerator and denominator by the radical in the denominator, so that's going to give me then, in the end, 5 root 3 over 3. Root 3 times root 3 is root 9, but root 9 is 3. And then the last one, using the quotient property of roots. Here I have the square root of 75x to the 4th divided by 2, so I'll just break that up into the square root. So largest perfect square factor of 75 is 25, and times the square root of 3 times the square root of x to the 4th all over the square root of 2, and the square root of 25 is 5. In here, keep in mind that the index there is 2, so 4 divided by 2 is 2, so this is going to be x squared times root 3 all over root 2. And then I rationalize the denominator, so I multiply by root 2, and then this will give me, so 5 x squared, and then root 3 times root 2 is root 6, so this would be root 6 all divided by root 4, which is 2. Root 2 times root 2 is root 4, which is 2. Okay, so that was using the quotient property, okay, the quotient property of roots. So as you have homework problems, just review those, and you guys should be fine with those. And then, okay, so now we're going to look at rational exponents. So I can write rational exponents as radical expressions. Okay, as I told you yesterday, a couple days ago, you should be able to go from radicals to rational exponents, from rational exponents to radicals pretty easily, and that's what we're going to be doing today. So a rational exponent is an exponent that can be expressed as m divided by n. Remember, rational meaning ratio, or ratio meaning fraction, where m and n are integers and n is not equal to 0 because we can't divide by 0. Okay, so we have these two important properties of rational exponents. we say that the a raised to the 1 over n is equal to the nth root of 8. Okay, yeah, some of you guys may be familiar with that. We've had things like this throughout the school year, like 9 raised to 1 half. I would always say, well, that's the square root of 9. But we never write the index 2. Square root of 9 equals 3. Okay, but the more general case is that we say that a raised to the m divided by n is just equal to the nth root of a raised to the m. So that's one way you can look at it. The nth root of a raised to the m, or it's the nth root of a raised to the m, with the m being underneath the radical. And most of the times, though, we'll use this. Okay, rarely do we ever use that because that makes things a little more difficult. Okay, sometimes it's much easier to figure out like the nth root of a than to take a and raise it to the m and then figure out the nth root of that. Okay, sometimes that's a lot more difficult. All right, so let's just look at some examples here. Employing rational exponents, and we'll go from rational exponents to radical expressions. So there we go. So a raised to the m over n is equal to the nth root of a raised to the m, and again, or the nth root of a, and then we raise everything to the m. And again, most times we'll use that one there. You'll see it's a lot easier. All right. So for example, if I have 16 raised to the 1/4, okay, that's the same as saying. That's the same as saying the fourth root of 16 raised to the first, or the fourth root of just 16, and we raise that to the first. And of course, the fourth root of 16, that's equal to 2. And then what about the next one here? If I have negative 125 raised to 2/3. Well, I can write that. So that's a cube root of negative 125 raised to the second. Now, you don't want to take negative 125 and square it and then find the cube root. So like I say, most times we don't use that case. We'll just say, hey, that's equal to the square root of negative 125, and then we square everything. It's a lot easier to figure out, or the cube root of negative 125. A lot easier to figure out the cube root of negative 125 than it is to take negative 125, square it, and figure out the cube root of that. So the cube root of negative 125 is negative 5. So we have negative 5, and that we'll square that, and that will equal 25. And then, again, 64 raised to 1/3. That's just the cube root of 64. So taking the easy approach, we'll say, hey, that's the cube root of 64 raised to the first. Cube root of 64 is 4. And then a couple more examples. 4 raised to the 5/2. Well, that's just saying, hey, let's just take the square root of 4, get that answer, and raise everything to the fifth. Well, the square root of 4, and again, remember, we never really write the index 2 for square roots, okay? Even though I have the 2 shows there, we never really write the index for 2. So the square root of 4 is equal to 2, and 2 to the 5th, that will equal 32. And then lastly, 8 raised to 2/3, well, that's just the cube root of 8, and then we evaluate that and square things. The cube root of 8 is 2, and then 2 squared is equal to 4. Okay? So again, we're going from rational exponents to radical expressions. Right. Rational to radical expressions. Now we'll go back the other way. So I can write radical expressions as rational exponents. So let's say here I have the fifth root of 7 raised to the 10th. Or if you wanted to, that would be the fifth root of 7 and raised to the 10th. Well, I can just write this as 7 raised to the 10 over 5. So 7 raised to the 10 over 5. Again, just using the fact that I can write a radical expression with rational exponents. And then 10 divided by 5 is 2, so I can simplify this 7 squared. I believe your homework is going to ask you to write from radical expressions to rational exponents. But here, I can even evaluate that, because 7 squared is equal to 49. Although in your homework, if it asks you to go from radical to rational exponents, that would be sufficient. So simplified, though, 10 divided by 5 is 2. And then how about this one here? The square root, remember again, the exponent, the index there is 2. So this would just equal, so my base would be 7, and then this would be 3 over 2. So that would be written in as rational. So the square root of 7 to the third is just equal to 7 raised to 3 halves. And how about this, the fourth root of 16 squared? Well, again, using rational exponents, that would be 16 raised to 2 fourths. 16 raised to 2 fourths, which is just 16 raised to 1 half. And again, this answer, so that answer would be sufficient, but you can even simplify that. 16 raised to the 1 half is the square root of 16, which is just 4. All right, so we're going from radical expressions to rational exponents in each case. All right, again, using that important property that a raised to the m over n is equal to the nth root of a raised to the m, or is equal to the nth root of a, and then you raise that to the m. But again, like I said, most times though, we'll use that one there. All right, so now show me what you can do. All right, so to do, I want you to simplify the radicals 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, simplify the radicals. Remember to rationalize your denominator if you have to. So look at those examples that I previously did. And then I want you to do those problems there. Okay, 13, 14, 15, and 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So you have a total of 8. And then 4 more problems, 12. So 12 problems in total. It shouldn't take you too long. Review the video if you get stuck, or join my WebEx. So one more lesson, guys, and then that is it. We'll call it for the trimester, and then we'll review. All right, so complete your work and turn it in as before, and then we'll continue on.